Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Welcome to this Beast Award ceremony in honor of Mrs. Ameena Saiyid. I would like to invite His Excellency Mr. Philippe Thiebaud, Ambassador of France to Pakistan, to deliver his speech.
Good evening. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, it's certainly for me a privilege to grant today to Ameena Saiyid this award from the French government, this knighthood in the order of Arts et Lettres, art and literatures, is really a very well-deserved recognition of the French government for all your career, for all your dedication to culture, to art, and to literatures here in Pakistan. In front of your many friends here, I will certainly not make a long story of the success story you did about Oxford University Press. It is an incredible achievement, and in a few decades, you have made Oxford University Press here one of the major vehicles for exchange of culture, for dialogue between cultures, and in all areas, you have been able to give to the rest of the world a good understanding of what is real Pakistan in the area of arts, literature, but also economy, sociology. But in all areas, thanks to you, thanks to all the books which were published by Oxford University Press, I think all the rest of the world is now aware of all the achievement of these countries. You have been a very successful leader for Oxford University Press. You have been also a very successful leader for the business community here in Karachi. And in the International Chamber of Commerce, you were the chairperson in 2010 and 2011. In many business circles, you have been tremendously helpful for the cooperation between Pakistani companies, Pakistan, and foreign investors and foreign friends of Pakistan. Of course, no need to say, you made of this Karachi Literature Festival one of the major cultural event in Pakistan. Since the inception of this festival 4 years ago, it is year after year a growing success, and I think the presence of many foreign visitors, of many friends of Pakistan here today, is a perfect example, a perfect testimony of this success, of this real development of dialogue of cultures between Pakistan and between the rest of the world. And we are very happy, for example, that some French writers, thanks to you, who are dedicating their research to Pakistan, to Sufism, to Sindh, have been able to publish here books which will really show the great interest we are paying to Pakistan, to its culture, but also which will enable French people to be better aware of what has been done here in this country. You have been promoting not only literature, but also culture and art of Pakistan. I had the pleasure to visit your offices, which are a good example of a wonderful presentation of Pakistan art, of Pakistan craftsmanship, of Pakistan sense of architecture, of art. And in all those areas, thanks to you, really, Karachi is a vibrant city, is a city which is better known. Unfortunately, time to time, the headlines of the newspapers are on the bad side of the city, on sectarian violences, on corruption, on ethnical fightings. But you help in giving the real image of the country, in proving how this city is vibrant, how this city is dynamic, how it's able to develop economic capacity, to create, to be a nice place for all people who really want to improve the situation in Pakistan. You have been also very active in the area of promotion of human rights, and I know how helpful you have been in this regard, how successful you have been. So in all those areas, we really want to recognize, the French government really wants to recognize your major contribution to the development of the country, to the development of Pakistan, to the development of international relationship and to the cooperation with France. And it's really, for me, a very privileged moment to grant you this award and to say thank you on behalf of the French government for all your dedication to enhancing bilateral relationship between France and Pakistan. Thank you. Sorry, I have to speak French now. Ameena Saiyid, au nom du président de la République et en vertu des pouvoirs qui nous sont conférés, nous vous faisons chevalier dans l'ordre des arts et lettres.
And now I would like to invite Mrs. Ameena Saiyid to deliver her speech.
Excellency, the Ambassador of France, Excellency Consul General, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I am deeply gratified at the honor you have conferred on me, Excellency, of being admitted as a knight to the Order of Arts and Letters of the Republic of France. I am filled with emotions, both of pride and of humility. Pride, in fact, a special kind of pride, because it means that my small efforts, which was to be a labor of love, have achieved the highest level of recognition by France. I am most grateful. In the making of modern civilization, your country, France, has played a unique role. You have been the bearers of the torch of the classical Greek and Roman civilizations into the modern world, a world which French scientists and engineers have helped to build. French scholars and philosophers have defined and developed the conceptual contours of the human mind. French painters, writers, filmmakers, and other artists have enriched the cultural life of the country, of the world, enormously. In my capacity as head of Oxford University Press, I have sought in a number of ways to work with French scholars and authors, and with Pakistani scholars and authors, and with scholars and authors from countries around the world, including Britain, the US, Germany, Italy, Bangladesh, and India. For our readers here, we have tried to publish books that are relevant to Pakistan, that promote the real image of Pakistan, an image of scholarship and research and academic work, because we have a wide range of authors and researchers who are working around the world. At the same time, we have published some French classic writers, such as Jules Verne and Guy de Maupassant, in both complete versions and also in simplified versions so that children in schools can read them. Amongst contemporary French writers, we have published Jean-Luc Racine, Annie Krieger, Michel Bovin, and Laurent Geyer, who is here today. With Dr. Bovin, we are working to develop a series of publications of the Center of Social Studies, Karachi, based at the Alliance Francaise. The first book of this series, which is meant to promote scholarship and learning on issues related to societies and cultures among Sindh and Muslims of South Asia. The first book, Reinterpreting the Sindhi World, has already been published. I'm also proud of having had the opportunity to visit the Center of South Asian Studies in Paris and to interact with scholars and researchers over there. And this brings me back to another emotion I feel at this conferment today, humility. The magnitude and variety of tasks ahead that we can jointly undertake is enormous. Finally, Excellency, it remains for me to once more express my immense happiness at the honor you have conferred on me. I will endeavor to live up to the noble aims of the Order of Arts and Letters. Thank you.
Thank you, and now I would like to invite the Honorable Assembly to proceed to the buffet where reception is offered in honor of Mrs. Ameena Saiyid. Thank you.
Take one of me with